six deacons. Deacon Samuel Naulak, Deacon Joseph Mungin, Deacon Chithung Joy, Deacon Dilbung, Milan, Deacon Athikho, and Deacon Yursem David. A beautiful day. Many years they have prepared themselves for this day. And in the midst of the people of God, clergy and the believers, they are going to make the public commitment to the Lord. We are here to witness that and to assist them with our prayers. Secondly, today is also a beautiful day because this cathedral, St. Joseph's Cathedral, celebrates its anniversary of its dedication. It's a mother church of the Archdiocese. And we are very, very happy. That gives us double joy. With this sentiments of joy, happiness, we come around the altar, thank the Lord for His manifold blessings, and to beg of His pardon for many failings of ours. Let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate this Eucharist.
To Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned, and to those in my words, what I have done, and what I have failed to do, forgive me, Lord.
Amen. Bethlehem Ephrathah, who are little to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is the ruler of Israel, whose origins from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she, who is in travail, has been brought forth. Then the rest of his brethren shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall dwell secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and this shall be peace. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Mary arose and went in haste into the hill country, to a city of Judah. And she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greetings of Mary, the babe leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. And she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the voice of your greeting came to my ears, the babe in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
The ordination ceremony for the benefit of those who came late, I request all of us to switch off our mobile phones, and no one will be allowed to take videos or photos during the ceremony. Before the homily, we have three important rites. First, calling of the candidates. Second, presentation of the candidates. And third, election by yourself and the consent of the people. The great ordination ceremony already direct. Gospel Matum Sida Equina Yamanaru Poiba ceremony of whom they candidate Sumbu Oviva Amasum.
Let deacons who are to be ordained priests please come forward. Deacons of Naulak.
Present.
Deacon Joseph Haomuanlian. Deacon Chithung Joel.
Present.
Deacon Dilbung Milan. Deacon Athikho, I said.
Present.
Deacon Yursem David.
Present.
Now the candidates have come forward along with their parents. Now the parents will in silence pray and bless their beloved sons before they offer to the Archdiocese for the service of God and the church. Jose, the dancing imam passing the Mahoyi Sisarba, Machari Basin Boom, Archbishop Gonda, Pitopoki Mamang Sida, Prayer, Blessing, Prathana, Isolgi Board, TV Naba, Adu, Tumina, Matam Prato Vigani, Equestis of Yawsi. Now the deacons are kneeling in front of their beloved parents to receive their blessings, to have God's blessing for their life mission. Let us join them. Now we will have removal of the cultural attires. The deacons are dressed in their traditional costumes as a sign that they belong to a tribe, a culture. This they can never lose till the end of their lives. But they have removed this to show that they have given themselves for the church, and they will embrace all cultures. Jose, everybody, he can sing, not only cultural costume sing, local ties or trick. Now we have presentation to the Archbishop. The Archbishop is the successor of the apostles, who has the authority to lay hands, to pass on the power to celebrate the Eucharist, so that the presence of Jesus in the community is concretely present in the Eucharistic celebration and the Eucharistic speeches. So now we'll have the parents handing over their beloved sons to the Archbishop. Jose, Mama Pasingna, Achan Archbishop Monda, Mahoyi Machasing, Isong Itamak, Kat Chaba Ajumi, Taurakan. Tiket, Samuel Nehaumut Naulak, Haomuanlian, Deacon Chithung, Deacon Dilbung, Milan, Deacon Athikho, Deacon Yursem David, President of the candidates, was it a political general? Candidate Sumu, Archbishop of the Cathedral. Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, for service as priests.
You judge them to be worthy.
After inquiry among the people of Christ and upon recommendation of those concerned with their training, I testify that they have been found worthy.
We rely on the help of Lord God and our Savior Jesus Christ, and we choose this man, our brothers, for the order of priesthood.
Thanks be to God, I say.
Thanks be to God.
When the day of anointing, you will be made partakers in the priesthood of Jesus Christ, the eternal priest, in the order of Melchizedek. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, you will be configured to the person of Jesus Christ, the head. The letter to the Hebrews speaks. Every high priest chosen from among men is appointed to act on behalf of men in relation to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. Goes on, and no one takes this honor on himself, but he is called by God, just as Aaron was. Hence, priesthood is a call, not a career. In a call, you do what you are called for. In a career, you do what you choose to do. You are called not because you are worthy or qualified, but you are called unworthy as you are and qualified. You are called for the mission of service. Through the rite of ordination, you are configured to Christ, to the person of Christ, the head. You are to conform to him, or model yourselves upon him, of Jesus Christ, who came to serve, not to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. You are to take up your cross daily and follow the Master without looking back. You are called for the service of the world. You are to meditate on what you preach and put into practice what you preach. Daily meditation on the word is essential for the effectiveness of your ministry. For no one can give what one does not have. You are to nourish the faithful with the sacraments, especially with the Eucharist. You are advised, know what you are doing and imitate the mystery you celebrate. Model your life on the mystery of the Lord's cross. You are to be in constant communion with the Lord through your prayer, life of prayer. You are an official prayer, one who prays for the people and with the people through the official prayer of the Church. You are to lead and govern the faithful more by your life of witnessing, rather than by word of mouth. Verse 16 said, and what is this offering which we are called to make, if not to die? to praise as a living sacrifice. Everything, every Christian, everything Christians do, everything done with their body, is to be holy and acceptable while being offered to the Father as a sacrifice. Christians' daily activities are a means of sanctifying themselves and the world. In the groups and dear brothers, never be lying in sin, but keep your spiritual cover, that means be set on that.
Examination of the candidates. Now the candidates will come before the Archbishop to be examined and questioned whether they know the dignity, duty and responsibility of their call to the priesthood. Bishop Imam Masjid Mahabdu Jesus was obedient unto death. The life of a priest is also one of obedience for the salvation of souls. Now, the candidates will promise obedience to the bishop, to his successors, and to the superiors placed over them.
Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
Do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God bless you to come, the good word that you bring to fulfill. Do you promise respect and obedience to your ordinary?
I do.
And God has given a good word in you, maybe to fulfill it. Do you promise respect and obedience to your ordinary?
I do.
And God has given a good word in you, maybe to fulfill it.
Pray for us. hear us, Lord our God, and pour out upon these servants of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit, and the grace and power of the priesthood. In your sight, we offer this man for ordination. Support them with your unfailing love. We ask them to Christ our Lord.
In silence. Silence is the sign that it is not the bishop who is doing, but it is the spirit who is using the archbishop as a medium to impart the power of succession to the candidates. After the bishop lays the hand, all the priests are also requested to come in line anti-clockwise and lay their hands and keep extending the right hand till the completion of the prayer of consecration. So that the Spirit may be poured profusely on the candidates and that they be filled with the grace of the Holy Spirit. We shall go anti-clockwise from my side, go in line and come through this.
Please stand, number 9. Please
take
number 9 from the
booklet. 9.
Please be seated. Please take number 8 from the booklet.
Hey.
they take up the ministry that they receive from you, O God, and be followers, models of Christ's coming. They may be faithful to work in the job of Jesus, so that the words of the gospel may reach the ends of the earth, and the fact of the patience made by the Christ may become God's one holy people. We ask that the Father of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. 의코이나 생톡자박이 아마성 까자박이 브라티나루이신 락크레 어제게 의코이 인베스티저 윗 스톨 앤 조세범
The duty of a priest is to lead the community in liturgical worship and liturgical worship is a sacred action which requires particular grace and values Now we will have the investiture of the candidates with Stor and Joseph. I request the fathers chosen by the candidates to help them in putting on their garment to come and help them to dress with their Stor and Joseph. Oje, ikoy kandidat singa, liangyati amasung prohiti kiro adu, libgani prohihay kasi sing matapat tuloy, maramasinga mapoisyo special dress for it. Ikoy Old Testament na biblikas lagi, prescribe Tawagin, maramasin na si Kirol siga, mapoy na community worship siya, may bulutin dito na, mapoy mo yung experience, hindi na kaya si Ekoy Gay, aning ba ni Ekoy Gay Pasan, kasi kasi doon yung mga kong siya, Ekoy na to bino kasi anointing of hands. We will now have anointing of hands with the chrism oil. In the Old Testament, priests, prophets, and kings were anointed for special service to God and to the people. So our deacons ask priests to be anointed by the Archdiocese with chrism oil to sanctify them, to empower them with the Spirit for their mission.
The Father anointed our Lord Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit. May Jesus present you to sanctify the Christian people and to offer sacrifice to God.
As anointing is going on, you will sing and hymn to the Holy Spirit.
Please take number 7 from the book.
Thank you.
Now we have the presentation of the gifts. The gifts will now be presented, the chalice and the baton, to offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass in order to invoke the presence of God among His people in the Eucharistic celebration.
Thank you.
quick act of a drink of system.
Thank you.
glory of his name, of his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just that we can be empowered with power to whom all blessed blessings are Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the Lord
God. In the name of the Lord. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just that you came out of salvation, all grace and everything in thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles and the prophets, for the old dream, the Virgin Mother longs for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. By his gifts that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his grace. And so the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, may sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
And blessed your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through your merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting hand.
Therefore, we pray and graciously accept this occasion of our service, that of your whole family, Father, that gave your peace, and command that that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, Lord, we pray, to bless us, God, and the Lord be our so that we may not oppress the body and blood of those who have suffered sorrow of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before we must suffer, we could pray and we stand for the venerable man and the highest grace to heaven, to you, O God, almighty Father, giving thanks.
Grant them, O Lord, we pray, that all who sleep in Christ
a place of refreshment, light and peace.
To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope your abundant mercies, graciously grant us some share and fellowship with the other apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, and Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not away our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
To whom you continue to be all the angels and the Lord, and you sanctify and fill them with life, bless them and restore them to all us.
To
thank you.
Please take number 16 from the booklet, 16. Or use number 5757.
Thank you.
congregation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. On the Archdiocese of Imphal for gracing this occasion by presiding over the Eucharistic celebration. Thank you, Your Grace, for your constant prayerful support throughout our journey to priesthood. We continue to seek your blessings and accompaniment for the days ahead. We take this opportunity to voice our grateful heart to His Grace, Most Reverend Joseph Bittani, the Archbishop Emeritus of Imphal, for his fatherly love, encouragement, and prayerful support. Your Grace, may God bless you with good health and the grace you need each day. We also acknowledge our gratitude and thankfulness to Right Reverend George Parikramudan, the Bishop of Miao Diocese, Reverend Father Joseph, the Provincial of Salesians of Don Bosco, Dimapu Province, Reverend Father Emmanuel, Provincial of MSFS Dibugar Province, and Reverend Father Sabu Francis, Provincial of MSFS Gohati Province, for their support and prayers. Dear Your Lordship and dear fathers, please do continue to support us with your prayers. We thank Reverend Father John Sefer, the Vicar General of Archdiocese of Imphal, for his prayerful support and encouragement. Thank you, Reverend Father Solomon, the Chancellor of the Archdiocese of Imphal, and Reverend Father Stanis Cook, the MC of today's liturgy, for the pains you have taken to make this event memorable and successful. Thank you, our commanders, past and present, who were torch bearers during our journey. Thank you so much, dear fathers, for your guidance and help. Our special thanks to Reverend Father Dizzo, the Parish Priest, and Reverend Father Dennis, the Assistant Parish Priest of St. Joseph's Cathedral, and Sisters of Sacred Heart Convent, for your hospitality and beautiful decorations to make the liturgy more meaningful, and your constant support and prayers, and all the possible help extended in various ways. Someone rightly said, feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. We extend our warm thanks to all of you dear fathers and sisters present here for your valuable prayers, good wishes, and blessings, which indeed has made this celebration more meaningful for us. Our sincere thanks to Reverend Father Rector and Community of St. Thomas Seminary, and Reverend Sister Provincial Superior and Community of Clarice Hall, and the choir members of today's celebration. Thank you so much for the hard work you put in to make this celebration a divine experience and make the liturgy lively and help us pray better. Thank you so much for your labor of love and generosity. Our thanks goes to Reverend Father Linus Lilly and Sisters at Retreat House for their constant concern, so in various ways. We cannot but say a big thank you to all of our benefactors and well-wishers and all present here. We are well aware of the great and laudable contributions you have made towards our growth. May God always keep you in His constant love and care. It is widely acknowledged that if the only prayer you said in your whole life was a thank you, that would suffice. Yes, our very dear parents. We thank God for you each day in pray and remember you, for the inestimable gift of you to each of us. It is because of your love, deep faith, life, word and example that water the seed of vocation in us. It is all because of you we have seen the dawn of this great day in our lives, and we have been able to dedicate ourselves entirely to God. Thank you for helping us to say yes to God's call, for offering us generously to God at this service. Since the day we left home, you have never ceased to pray for us. Our hearts overflow with gratitude to God for giving us such spiritual and God-fearing parents, whom we hold very dear. We ask you to bless us and to continue to strengthen our vocation through your constant prayers as we begin our priestly ministry. Thank you, one and all.
Someone now welcome your words of thanks on behalf of your friends. May the Lord continue to bless you all with thankful hearts, because thankful heart is a joyful heart. Now I call upon the representative of the diocesan fraternity to welcome our newly ordained priest.
Your Grace, most Reverend Dominic Newman, the Archbishop of Imphal, Very Reverend Father John Kashkrin, the Vicar General, representatives of provincials and provincial representatives of the MSFS congregation and the Salesians of Don Bosco, dear fathers, sisters, their parents of the newly ordained priest today, and my dear invitees and people of God. It gives me great privilege today to stand before you to welcome the newly ordained priests on behalf of the Diocesan Fraternity of Imphal. Dear Reverend Father Samuel Naulak, Reverend Father Joseph Haomuanlian, Reverend Father Chithung, Reverend Father Dilbung, Milan, Reverend Father Athikho, Reverend Father Yursem David, I stand here on behalf of the fraternity of priests, not just the, or perhaps you can say it, not just the Archdiocese, the Diocesan priests of Imphal, but the fraternity of priests, to welcome you into this new journey that you have embarked on. Dear fathers, congratulations to you on your ordination. You have prepared many years to this day, and this day has seen the light. We appreciate your endurance, your commitment to serve as servants of God. Dear fathers, priesthood, as you all know, is a noble vocation. It has plenty of joys as much as it has plenty of struggles. You will have plenty of people praising you, and many people not praising you, but criticizing you sometimes. We know many things that, some certain things that the lay people know, we do not know. Many things that the people of God do not know, we know. And sometimes, in the midst of this, we sail through, alone, but with God. You will have plenty things to bear up with, and you will have plenty things to give. Welcome to this bandwagon of the servants of God and His people. I wish you a happy ministry. I wish you success and fulfillment in your ministry as priests. Wherever you may be working, I wish that you enjoy your work. Father Samuel Naulak and Father Joseph Haomuanlian belongs to the Archdiocese of Imphal. Father Dilbung Milan belongs to the Diocese of Miao. Father Chithung Joel and Father Athikho belongs to the congregation of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales. And Father David Yursem belongs to the Salesians of Don Bosco. But all of them belong to the family of priests. welcome dear fathers, and let us give them a big hand. Wonderful young heroic priests, we thank you immensely for handing over generously your beloved sons to the church. They are second to none, I know. You hold them very dear, but you hold them with great appreciation also. This day, Thank you very much and have a great day.
Thank you for the words of welcome and encouragement to our new priests. In our Archdiocese, the youth part is very formidable and it's difficult to stop them when they want to do something. So seeing six young men giving themselves for God in the church, they seem excited. Let's give them a minute or two to express their sentiments.
Amen.
Be meek to servants and witnesses to the Lord.
and congratulate. Our mothers would like to speak something and give a small present to our newly ordained priest.
I, on behalf of Manipur Catholic Women Organization, the organization which all your mothers belong to, we want to congratulate you, dear fathers, on this ordination of yours. We, your mothers, always pray for you, and we wish you all the best as you undertake this missionary journey of yours. As a sign of our love and our gratitude for your service to the church, we want to hand over a small gift to each and every one of you. Please accept it with love. Thank you.
We also have a very devout couple coming all the way from Arunachal Pradesh. They also want to express their joy by presenting something to the fathers.
First of all, congratulations to this young Sikh priest who have just now ordained. From the core of my heart, may God bless you and in all your endeavors in future in your mission. Congratulations. I have come from Ithanagar. I'm Takam Titus, a government official from Arunachal government. Congratulations once again. Congratulations. I have nothing to give, just a small gift, that is muffler from our mission society where we express as a token of love. I would like to request Father David to come forward and
thank you very much, Sir Titus and wife, for your show of love. This definitely show our universality, whether you are in Arunachal or in Nagaland or in Manipur, by faith we are one. So thank you very much for this expression of love. We appreciate your gesture very much. May God bless you both, and also may God bless Arunachal Pradesh so that we have many, many priests and missionaries from that place as well. Let's clap for them. Thank you very much. I request His Grace and the provincials and fathers to come, kindly come over this side. Place is prepared for them. Now, once again, on behalf of all of us, I would like to congratulate all our newly ordained priests for the brave step that they have taken, and we want to congratulate them and assure them that we continue to pray for them. So now may I request them to come together, cut the cake. After cutting the cake, we will sing the congratulations song. This will be immediately followed by the prayer for the grace by Father Joseph Kurvatira, the provincial of the Salesian province of Imphal.
Yes, to His love. So here we sing, come
you offer to the Lord. Precious you are and you will be, for he has called you by name to be his loyal shepherd. So here we sing congratulations for the life you offer to the Lord. So here we sing congratulations for the life you offer to the Lord. As you step out to walk in his vineyard, may the Lord be your ever God. This is our prayer for you, dear fathers. So here we sing congratulations for the life you offer to the Lord. So here we sing congratulations for the life you offer to the Lord. We thank God for the courage you take to bear his witness to the world and to continue his mission. So here we sing congratulations for the life you offer to the Lord. So here we sing congratulations for the love you offer to the Lord. May you live forever as all he has completed a priest.
Thank you very much to our seminarians and the candidates of FCC Mantipukri for your congratulations songs. Now we'll have prayer before the meal. Before that, a small announcement. Since the relatives and friends of the newly ordained priest 28, they will be going back immediately after the meals. I request all the parishioners to give preference to our guests. Therefore, soon after the prayer, meal will be served. Please kindly let us give preference to the guests who have come from far since they have to go back. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God, our loving Father, in your infinite love you created us and gave us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ, and formed us into a community of the faithful. In order to take care of your faithful people, you constantly give us shepherds after your own heart. Today, through the laying on of hands of Archbishop Dominic, you have given us 6 more priests to the church. We ask you to bless all these new priests. Give them all the graces required to live their state of life as priests and be pastors for the people. Through this priest, you will be breaking for us the word of God, and the sacraments will be celebrated for us in order to enrich us spiritually, to nourish us spiritually. As a provident father, you care not only for our spiritual needs, but also for our material needs. And you have prepared for us a festive meal to be taken part as a community. Bless all those who worked hard to prepare it. Bless all those who will be serving the meal for us. And bless all of us who will be taking part in this meal, so that we may be strengthened to be faithful to your call and do your will on a daily basis, so that the church may grow and that the community may grow and that we may grow. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Look into the mirror, Lord, you're who I want to see. While I'm walking in this world, Father, I want the world to see, not me, but Jesus living in me. Every day our lives are on display. Does the way we live reflect the words we say? Are we setting an example by what we do? When the world looks at us, do they see you? I want to see Jesus in me when I look into the mirror, Lord. You're who I want to see while I'm walking in this world, Father. I want the world to see not me, but Jesus living in me. If we claim to live for you and that we follow your call, watching closely to see if we stand or fall. So as we walk our daily walk, and as we talk our daily talk, let it be you living in us that they see. Change my heart, Lord, let my life reflect Jesus. Let your light shine through me for the world to see. Give me courage, give me strength to live for you in all that I do. Help me reach out in your love to a world in need. I want to see Jesus in Jesus in me. When I look into the mirror, Lord, you're who I want to see. Not me, but Jesus living in me. Every day our lives are on display. Does the way we live reflect the words we say? Are we setting an example by what we do? When the world looks at us, do they see you? I want to see Jesus in me when I look into you.